For all the wave cells, what's really new this year, we really worked on new materials. Our power fuse got redesigned, and there is a new way how we are building those panels. So we are still using this variable progressive thickness, but instead of putting just the fingers over the top of a base, now they're actually interlocking, overlapping pieces that form the panel. The result is that we get panels that are even stronger than before and slightly lighter. So that's I'm really happy about that development, and that these panels you will find on all of the wave cells, so Atlas, Combat, and Zone. The other also thing that you will see new on Atlas and Combat, not on Zone, because Zone it's having the Dacron Love panel, but Atlas and Combat are featuring new material we developed, which combines sort of the best properties of Dacron and laminated materials. So we call it the taffeta reinforced laminate. And it sits, it has a springiness of laminated materials, but the extra forgiveness, and especially it's a very heavy duty material, so it holds the stitches and it prevents any breakages at the high load areas like the love panel.
The wave cell range for 2022, it's the sales that you all know and love. It's the Atlas, the Combat, and the Zone. The Combat, which is pretty much, I think, the most widely sold sail in the whole world. It's a sail that pretty much all of the pro riders choose to use on tour just because it's so versatile. Four battens, very light in the hands. We've actually changed the Combat quite a lot this year. We've used some new materials in the top of the sail that lets it twist off a little bit more gently, and it's a little bit smoother through the gusts. You can also rig it very full and the sail doesn't really feel backhanded. And then you can also flatten it off quite a lot. So the wind range of the Combat has improved, and the handling in high winds has improved a lot.
When we talk about the design changes, we found a way to make the sail even more depowered, but make sure we are not losing any of the power that people like to the Combat. So I would say there is more change in between full on and off when you sheet in, sheet out. So the sail, it's delivers plenty of power to get you even through the onshore conditions and so, but once you're on the wave, if you depower, the combination of lighter weight, new construction, and flatter profile that flattens on the wave makes it just super light in handling.
I also find that I can rig it really full and then use a slightly smaller size sail at Hookeeper, which is something I really like to do. I feel like the smaller the sail that you can get away with using improves your performance and improves the ratio of makes on tricks. So being able to rig the sail slightly fuller and use a smaller sail helps a lot, especially in places where you're doing down the line sailing and the wind's quite strong offshore.
So with the new Zone, here we kept the actual love curve and the shaping of the sail that was working really well, and the concept with the Dacron love panel, which gives this extra softness to the sail. But what's really new, it's we introduced the same frame concept in the construction, in the materials of the rest of the sail. So same like at the Combat, we have this high density outer frame that takes all the load and keeps the sail nice and springy. And then we have a lightweight inner materials, the center panel, that reduce the weight and give this softness when riding. So that's the main changes with the Zone.
Particularly at Hookeeper, I'm always on the Zone. I like the down the line feel, feels light in the hands, depowers, you know, has a good amount of twist. So that's why I mainly use that sail for down the line conditions. And if I'm traveling, you know, other places that has a little bit more onshore conditions, I'll definitely switch to the Combat. Has a little bit more stability, a bit more grunt, just feels better in those onshore conditions.
The Atlas is more for onshore and heavier sailors, maybe leaning towards bump and jump as well. It's also good in down the line conditions for the bigger, heavier sailor that likes a five batten feel and a bit more stability.
So with the Atlas was again a sail we totally redesigned. Same like with the Combat and Zone, it's featuring new panel out, the new materials, the frame concept. But other than that, was really important for us with the Atlas to keep that drive, that power that the sail is really known for. It can be used, it's like ideal onshore sail, but it also can be used even on the flat water or even in the, now with the new materials, even in the sideshore. Because what's happening, the new materials gave the sail extra softness, extra forgiveness. It took away this kind of sometimes too direct feel that the Atlas was known for, so there is a little bit more damping and it makes the sail just much more of a wave sail than before.